Assalamu alaikum students, hope you all are fine. Today we will study about the locomotion in mammals. In this lesson we will study that what is locomotion and what is movement and which organs of a body help to move a person or an animal. So let's start with the locomotion. What is locomotion and movement? Locomotion means movement or the ability to move from one place to another. And the movement is an act of moving. You can see in the picture, this picture showing a type of locomotion. A person moves from one place to the other, and the act of moving is known as movement, and the ability to move is known as locomotion. So the question is, why do animals need to do locomotion? There are many reasons for this. Animals need to do locomotion because they need to search for food, water, and shelter. They need to escape from danger, for example, prey. They need to avoid unfavorable conditions, for example, migration. If they face any unfavorable condition, they will migrate or they will move from that place to another where they will be safe. And the other reason is to reproduce or to find a mate. Firstly, we will discuss about the movement in animals and then specifically we will discuss about the mammals. So let a brief introduction about the movement in animals. All animals move at some time in their life. Even those animals which are fixed or stationary begin life as free-swimming organisms. In certain organisms, the life cycle consists of a sedentary means polyp generation, alternating with a swimming medusae. These are the stages present in the life of an organism. So I repeat that in certain organisms, the life cycle consists of a sedentary generation alternating with a swimming generation. Sedentary generation is the polyp condition and the swimming generation is the medusae situation. For example, the jellyfish spends most of its life as medusae stage, while corals and sea anemones spend most of their lives as polyps. Most animals run, crawl, swim, fly with aid of limbs. The limbs are moved by muscles which are attached to the skeleton. When the muscles contract, they move the skeleton and with it part or all of the body. Not all animals need limbs to move quickly. For example, the snakes are limbless. A snake moves by forming its body into zigzag, gripping the ground with its underside and pushing itself forward. The fastest snake, the black mamba, can reach over 30 km per hour. Animals such as flatworms often move by undulating in a continuous ripple. This was an overview about the movement of animals. Organisms of locomotion in vertebrates. There are 5 classes of vertebrates. Pisces, amphibians, reptiles, avians, and mammals. Pisces includes the fishes, Amphibians include frogs, toads, salamander. Reptiles include snakes, turtles, crocodiles, and lizards. Avians include all the birds, and the mammals included the human, whales, dolphins, bats, horses, rays, bears, seals, and walruses, etc. Of these, members of the class Pisces are exclusively aquatic. Amphibians, certain reptiles, birds, and mammals are able to move on the land as well as in water. This picture shows how a hippopotamus moves by using its forelimbs and hind limbs both. So let's start with the mammals, movement in mammals. We have decided the human for discussion because it is easy to understand. The framework of the human body, the skeleton, the muscles and the skin is a strong yet flexible construct. The 206 bones that make up the adult skeleton support the body and work with muscles and nerves to move the body's various parts. The human body has about 650 muscles responsible for movement, and even the smallest motion requires at least two muscles working in opposition. For example, the opening and closing of the hand. All movements that change the positions of the bony parts of the body occurs at joints. The skeletal system consists of many separate bones, most of which are held together at joints by flexible connective tissues. Joints are necessary since bones are too rigid to bend without causing damage. This picture shows the movement of human. You can see that how a man is moving its feet to run. It all depends upon the shape and position and the rate of movement. For example, how fast or how slow the person is moved. Whatever the phenomena of moving is the same, but the level of energy will increase or decrease with respect to the rate of the movement. So this is a skeleton of a human body which shows different type of bones and different joints. The joints are the reason the body and the parts of body can move. Joints are the place where two bones meet. All of your bones except for one. The one is the hyoid bone in your neck. From a joint with another bone. Joint hold your bones together and allow your rigid skeleton to move. Some of your joints, like those in your skull, are fixed and don't allow any movement. The bones in your skull are held together with fibrous connective tissues. Other joints, such as those between the vertebrae in your spine, which are connected to each other by pairs of cartilage, can only move a small amount. The highlighted points in this picture are all the joints which are available in our body, like elbows and knees. So what is the sport and locomotion in humans and animals? As other organisms, the importance of sport and locomotion is equal in humans also. They also move in the search of food. They provide protection by escaping from enemies or avoiding danger. search for more conducive living environment, find mates for reproduction, and avoid overcrowding, which enables the offspring to move to another place. These are all the reasons which any animal or any mammal use to locomotion. As the skeletal system is the main part of used for the locomotion or the movement. So the human skeletal system, it consists on two main parts, axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. The axial skeleton consists on skull, vertebral column and the rib cage, while the appendicular skeleton consists on the pectoral girdle, arms or also called the forelimbs, pelvic girdle and legs or the hind limbs. The skull consists on the bones, cranium, bones of the face and jaw. Vertebral column, the backbone, consists on the vertebrae, lumbar vertebrae, sacrum, coccyx. And the rib cage consists on the sternum and ribs. While in the appendicular skeleton, the pectoral girdle consists on the scapula and clavicle. Arms or the forelimbs consist on the humerus, ulna, radius, carpals, metacarpals, phalanges, ischium, pubis, etc. And in the legs, the femur, tibia, fibula, tarsals, metatarsals and phalanges. The first is the skull. Skull consists on the cranium. Cranium enclose the protect the brain and enclose the brain. The second are the facial bones and jaws, which protect the eyes and ears. The upper jaw is fixed while the lower jaw is movable. Skull is joined to the vertebral column at the base of the cranium. The second is the ribs. 12 pair of ribs articulate with thoracic cavity dorsally and sternum ventrally. The sternum is the front part of the ribs. And the third is the vertebral column. The vertebral column is consists of 33 vertebrae joined by separated by disc of cartilage. The five types of vertebrae are present. Cervical vertebrae are 7 in number. Thoracic vertebrae are 12 in number. Lumbar vertebrae are 5 in number. Sacral vertebrae are 5 in number. And the fifth is the coccyx. So this is the picture of a vertebrae. The labeled part are neural arc, neural spine, neural canal and centrum. The function of neural arc is to form neural canal. The neural spine is for the muscle attachment. Neural canal is protect the spinal cord and the centrum gives support to the vertebrae. These are the three types of different vertebrae: cervical vertebrae, thoracic vertebrae, and lumbar vertebrae. The basic movement is mostly held by using the appendicular skeleton. The appendicular skeleton is consists on the forelimbs and the hind limbs, the pectoral girdles of forelimbs, and the pelvic girdle and hind limbs. Collectively are known as the arms and legs. These are the appendicular skeleton and these are the major source which is used for the movement or for the locomotion. So this is a picture of an arm. there is a clavicle present, scapula is for the sport, humerus is the upper part of the arm, ulna and radius are two bones present on the lower part of the bone. In the hand, you can see the carpals, metacarpals, phalanges and metaphalanges. These are all the parts which are movable. You can move your arm easily with the help of these joints. And the other part of appendicular skeleton is the leg. So the base of the leg is the pelvic girdle, which supports the whole leg. It consists, the upper side of the, upper part of the leg is consist on the femur, and the movable joint is the patella. Two bones like the arm is present in the leg also are known as tibia and fibula. And same as the hand, there are tarsals, metatarsals and phalanges present. These have maximum joints in it. So what are joints and how it works? Joints place where two bones meet. Bones are held together by ligaments. Synovial joints are the joints that contains a cavity filled with fluid. The end of bones are covered with cartilage. You can see in the picture, there are two bones are meet there and a ligament hold them collectively. In the center, the blue color is the representing joint fluid, which is known as synovial fluid. The bone ends are the cartilaginous and show in the white color. And the hard part of the bone is shown in the brown color. Here are various type of joints. The first is the hinge joint and the other is the ball and socket joint. Hinge joints are the joints which allow movement in one plane. For example, the joint of humerus and ulna. You can move your arm in a limited way. In a limited direction, you can't move it thoroughly. While the ball and socket joints are a low movement in all direction, for example, the joint of humerus and scapula. For example, the starting of your arm, you can move your whole arm in any direction, but you can't move your elbow. Movement in the limb. Skeletal muscles are attached to bones by tendons. Movement of caused by the antagonistic movement of muscles. One muscle is contracted and the other is relaxed. Structure of a muscle is consist on the muscle fibers and myofibrils. Muscle fibers are the single long cylindrical cells that contains many nuclei. The myofibrils are the smaller units that made up of muscle fibers. Interaction of actin and myosin will cause muscle contraction. Let me have a brief introduction about some type of locomotion. The major is the migration. Migration is more difficult undertaking for mammals than for birds or fishes because terrestrial locomotion is more energetically expensive than swimming or flying. Not surprisingly, few terrestrial mammals make regular seasonal migrations, preferring instead to center their activities in a defined and limited home range. Nevertheless, there are some striking terrestrial mammalian migrations. More migrators are found in North America than on any other continent. An example is barren ground caribou of Canada and Alaska, which undertake direct and purposeful mass migration spanning 160 to 1100 kilometers. If we convert into miles, it will be 100 to 700 miles, twice annually. From winter ranges in boreal forest, taiga, they migrate rapidly in late winters and spring to calving ranges on the barren grounds, tundra. Calves are born in mid-June. As summer progresses, caribou are increasingly harassed by warble and nostril flies that bore into their flesh, by mosquito that drink their blood, and by wolves they prey on their calves. They move southward in July and August, feeding little along the way. In September, they reach the taiga and feed there almost continuously on low ground vegetation. And the mating is occur in the October. The longest mammalian migrations are made by the oceanic seals and whales. Gray whales, for example, migrate between Alaska in summer and Baja California, Mexico in winter. An annual migration of over 18,000 kilometers or the 11,250 miles. One of the most remarkable migration is that of northern fur seals, which breed on the Pribilof Island, approximately 300 kilometers or 185 miles off the coast of Alaska and north of the Aleutian Islands. From wintering grounds of Southern California, females journey as much as 2800 kilometers or 1740 miles across open ocean. Arriving in the spring at the Pribilofs, where they congregate in enormous numbers. Young are born within a few hours or days after arrival of the cows. Then the bulls, having already arrived and established territories, collect groups of cows which they guard with vigilance. After calves have been nursed for approximately 3 months, cows and juveniles leave for their long migration southward. Bulls do not follow but remain in the Gulf of Alaska during the winter. Although we might expect bats, the only winged mammals, to use their gift of flight to migrate, few of them do. Most spend winters in hibernation. Four species of American bats that migrate spend their summer in northern or western states and their winters in the southern United States or Mexico. Locomotion in mammals, flight and echolocation. Many mammals scamper about in trees with amazing agility. Some can glide from tree to tree, and one group, the bats, has full flight. Gliding or flying evolved independently in several groups of mammals, including marsupials, rodents, flying lemurs, and bats. Flying squirrels actually glide rather than fly, using the gliding skin, patagium, that extends from the sides of the body. Bats are mostly nocturnal or crepuscular. For example, they can active at twilight and thus hold a niche unoccupied by most birds. Their achievement is attributed to two features, flight and capacity to navigate by echolocation. Together, these adaptations enable bats to fly and to avoid obstacles in absolute darkness. To locate and to catch insects with precision and to find their way deep into caves where they sleep during the daytime hours. Research has been concentrated on members of the family to which most common North American bats belong. When in flight, bats emit short pulses 5 to 10 meter seconds in duration in a narrow directed beam from the mouth or nose. So this was all about the locomotion and movement of the mammals, their structure and their way of locomotion. We have also discussed the reason of locomotion. So if you have any confusion or any question, you can ask. Thank you.